In our next tab, we see text flow, hyphenation, automatically. Let's turn on this automatic hyphenation and see how it works. They're set to two characters at the end of the line and two characters at line beginning. Clicking OK. Nothing's changed because it still fits in that line. But if I bold this word software, it's too big for the one line and hyphenates soft and where. Gives us two words with a dash in between. And the same should work with Outlook. So we see that it hyphenates two words because they're bigger than two letters. Going on, out has three. So if I change this to three, does anything? Well, line beginning, we don't need that one. It's the line end has three characters. Clicking three, nothing changes. But when I change this to four, now we should see Outlook goes, but because this one's four, I would have to change this to five to make it down. Going back, let me back up. Now we're back to having this. These both have four letters, so I'm going to just add an S to make this have five letters, and we're going to see the same thing with the beginning of line. So now we think if it's four characters, let's take this one back down to two so nothing's affected there. So now we have five. If there's at least five characters, so it should put Outlook on one line and software should stay on two. And it does, softwares. Let's look at this maximum number of consecutive hyphens. It's set at zero, which means it can have as many as there are or an infinite amount of hyphens. In our paragraph here, I see Thunderbird is hyphenated. So where we're at less, I'm going to delete the space. And now that is a hyphenated word. And going down one more line, doing things. So now we've got three hyphens in a row. Going back into our paragraph dialog box, I'm going to set this to two. So what we're expecting to happen here is we'll see two in the third one, it'll just force down to the next line. And it does. In this next section with breaks, insert a page break before means before this paragraph. The rest of the things that we'll have to talk about later after we do styles, but for now, we know that we can click on to add a page break before that paragraph just by clicking in the paragraph. Versus when you insert a manual break, it would break where your cursor is at. Okay, down in options, we have do not split paragraph. That means that if this paragraph is falling over into the next page, take the whole paragraph down to that next page. Clicking OK, we see how that works. And in this case, it just happened to work just like our insert a page break before, because that paragraph happened to be between two pages. The inserting the page break will jump down to the next page, whether that paragraph covers two pages or not. So just keep that in mind. And then keep with next paragraph. If you want the next paragraph as well to go down to the next page, if it crosses over that so that they are kept together, we'll see how that works more when we get into the bullets and numbering. Now we have orphan control and widow control. I'm kind of grouping them together because they're very similar. Looking down in our document a little further, we see in this paragraph that we have one line that seems to have fallen onto the next page. That's where the widow and orphan comes in. Actually, this is where the widow comes into play. When I click widow control, now we're saying don't let one line hang by itself, have at least two. So clicking OK, it grabs a line before it and brings it down. So now we've got two lines on the next page. And I can make that three or more or however many as we give it. Looking down further, I've got a paragraph with one line on the top or the bottom of the page above it. So to change that, I'm going to right-click, go back into paragraph text flow. This time, we've got the orphan, and I want to make that at least two lines. Since there won't be two lines, it's going to grab this line and bring it down to the next page, which it does.